We want to hear a motivation. We want to feel like we're believers. Allah says, I'll take care of you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, don't doubt people. Don't doubt people. Don't suspect for nothing. Yes, if there's reason to suspect, you may do so. But only if there's reason. If there's no reason, you don't suspect people. You don't spy on people. Allah says, leave it to us. Don't spy on people. Because if you spy, we want to teach you something. Allah says to us, I am the most merciful, the most forgiving. Someone might have committed a mistake. I will forgive them. They will change their lives. They will become... How many of us have been weak in the past? And we've committed sin. And we've changed our lives. And we no longer commit those sins. But we would be embarrassed to admit what type of sins we've committed in the past. Many of us. Don't you agree? Imagine if someone had to spy on you and knew what you were up to. They would never forgive you, or they would never look at you with the eye of positivity ever, because they knew what you were up to. But your life has changed. You're genuinely a changed person. Only Allah understands that. I tell you, my brothers and sisters, the whole world will let you down. Absolutely everyone will let you down, but Allah will not let you down. Allah says, my worshipper, I will forgive you by you just asking me for forgiveness, even if your sins were as much as would fill from the earth to the skies. You want to hear the words? Yabna Adama, law balagat dhunubuka anana as-sama'i thumma astaghfartani ghafartu laka wala ubali laqitani la tushriku bi shay'an. The hadith says, O son of Adam, if your sins had filled from the earth to the skies full of writing, meaning if they had filled that whole space, that's how many sins you came with on the day of judgment. But you came without associating partners with me. You worshipped me. You tried. I can forgive your sins without even being bothered. It won't really affect anything at all on my side. So Allah is telling us, O son of Adam, no matter what you've done, have hope in my mercy. O son of Adam, your acts of worship benefit you, they don't benefit me. So trust that I will accept them from you. Did you try? Yes, I tried. Accept it. Don't let the devil come to you and make you lose your faith in Allah. You have faith in Allah. What is the faith in Allah? He is Ghafoor, Rahim, Wadood. He is the loving, the most merciful, the most forgiving, the most compassionate. That is who Allah is. Have you ever thought about it? When we say Bismillahi, the first words as we're reading the Quran, what do we say? Bismillahi Ar-Rahmani Ar-Rahimi. In the name of Allah, what did He choose as the ultimate of the first two names for us to be repeating? What did He choose? Number one, Ar-Rahman. What's that? The most merciful, the entirely merciful. He is merciful even upon those who don't deserve His mercy. Subhanallah. That's what the meaning of Ar-Rahman. And then He says Ar-Rahim. He has a specialized mercy for those who believe. They will feel that mercy because of that belief and conviction. When you're convinced with Allah, when you rely on Allah, when you know that the good that came to me is definitely a blessing from Allah and a test, and the bad that came to me is also a blessing from Allah and a test, then you have true belief. Then you're a believer. But if you think the bad is always a punishment, it's not. It's not. You know, we have tsunamis, we have natural disasters, we have death, we have so many other things, disease, sickness. A lot of these things are actually a blessing from Allah. Yes, it can be a punishment. It's all got to do with your own condition. Someone said, oh, look at Allah punishing the people of Indonesia because of what they've been doing. And I got up and I said, it's my duty to tell you that that is not necessarily a punishment. What about those who died while they were in sujood? What about those who died while they were trying to read Quran? What about those who were decent people who died and they were martyred or perhaps killed in that natural disaster? Can you ever say that it was the punishment of Allah? No, it was not. It was the mercy of Allah upon them. They died in a good condition. How many of us would like to die in sujood? I would like to die in sujood. Yes. So if Allah took you away in sujood, no matter how He took you away, but isn't it a blessing of Allah? You'll be resurrected perhaps in a similar way. And people say, That guy was punished, you see, because he died natural disaster. You don't know. It was the mercy of Allah. But if someone was in the disobedience of Allah at the time, that's between them and Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not do that to us. So it could be the same disaster could be a punishment for some and a mercy for others, depending on how you are. And those who have survived, it depends on the condition of your heart. Those who have survived, it depends on the condition of your heart. Subhanallah. If you're a happy person, if you're always happy and you make the most of what's left with you, then you're definitely a believer. You believe in Allah. It's definitely a means of closeness to Allah. How many of us, when we've had disease and sickness, have we become better Muslims? Wow. So isn't that a sign of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It softened us. It made us fulfill salah. And how many of us, once we get cured, we're back with our old ways and habits? Allahu Akbar. May that not happen to us. May we always be from those whom, when we are cured, we change our lives as well. And not just sickness. People cry for things to Allah. Oh Allah, I need a child. I need a child. And mashallah, after 8 years, 10 years, 12 years, 14 years, I know, 18 years, I've known of one case. They were blessed with a child. Subhanallah. May Allah bless all of us with children. Ameen. Even if you're not married, just say Ameen. You might be laughing. Why? I can tell you why. When you say, oh Allah, grant me with good offspring who will be the coolness of my eyes, it's like a full package. It means, firstly, in order to get that, I need a husband, right? So that's included in it, okay? And I need, it's like if you don't have a job and you say, oh Allah, help me to buy a lovely expensive car. Just an example, right? It means you're firstly going to have to get a job and earn the money, or something's going to have to happen for the money to come to you, right? So in the same way, when you say, oh Allah, grant me pious offspring, it means, oh Allah, get me the best spouse, and thereafter with us, give us the good offspring. So it's an all-inclusive two-in-one, like the shampoo organics, mashallah. Okay, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. So my brothers and sisters, rely on Allah. I want to give you one example. I didn't realize that I've already just got 8 minutes left, but I think I'm going to overshoot today. It's not like we come to Cardiff every day. You know, they've got a long break. The reason why there's a very long break is there's two salahs there. And the timing's a little bit awkward. People are saying, why is the break so long? I can tell you, because we don't want to go out for a salah, come back, and then go back for another salah, and the timing is so short. Rather have that little break. You can have a snack. We can do a few other things, read the next salah, and then come back. That's why it's a little bit longer. So bear with us. Be happy, inshallah. Be happy. Allah grant us ease. May Allah open our doors. I give you an example. You see, Allah's promise is true. Ya ayyuha an-nasu inna wa'da Allahi haqqun. Oh people, Allah's promise to you is absolutely true. Wa man asdaqu min Allahi haditha wa man asdaqu min Allahi qila. Who can there be more truthful than Allah regarding his speech, regarding what he has said, regarding his promise? Kana ala rabbika wa'dan. When Allah promises us Jannah and paradise and goodness, He says, this is a promise that you can ask Allah about. You can hold Him responsible to the promise He's made. Allah said, whoever seeks forgiveness, I will forgive them. If you have sought forgiveness and you go on the day of judgment, you can ask Allah, oh Allah, I sought forgiveness, my forgiveness. You won't even need to ask Allah. Do you know why? It will definitely be that your sin is wiped out. Don't lose hope. Don't let shaitan trap you to make you believe otherwise. Now let me tell you, Allah promised you. Unfortunately, sometimes man is such, we're ready to believe another person, but we're not ready to believe Allah. Give you an example, beautiful example. Okay, so you're looking for a job and suddenly you find a job and they tell you, listen, you're going to be paid. You're going to be paid how much? What's a good salary per week, let's say? What's a good salary? Can someone say? Yes. $150, son, I think you're a bit too young, mashallah. Okay, say it. £500 a week, it's a good salary. Okay, someone's offering you £5,000 a week and they tell you, we pay you monthly. So what's that? How many weeks? 4 weeks. 20,000 a month. Oh, subhanallah. And What's the job? It's simple. You can just work at home. It's just online. You got to do X, Y, and Z. That's it. When you're done, you're okay. So you're working online a few hours, and what's happening? Every day you're excited. The fact that you got the job was so beautiful. You put your signature on there, or even if you just took the word for it, you're so excited. Finally and ultimately, someone has promised you that after 30 days, you're going to get 20,000 in your bank account. Wow. Wouldn't you be excited? I think I would, right? So now what happens when 20 days pass? You're so excited because you can start smelling the pounds, mashallah, right? 25 days, you can start smelling the perfumes you're going to be buying with those pounds, mashallah, right? 28 days and you're so excited, you're starting to plan your outing and how you're going to take your family and what you're going to, hope it's halal inshallah, but whatever else you're going to be doing, you start planning everything, you're excited because someone's promised you, you work 28 days, 30 days, I'm going to give you the salary, and you work hard and you're dedicated and you wouldn't like to lose the job and you don't want someone else to take over from you and you don't want someone else to prove that they're better than you so that you can be replaced, you don't want any of that, you work so hard and exactly 30 days later, a few hours delay and you're getting excited, you want to think of whether I should call management, my money's not reflecting and I need, and I've got this commitment and that commitment, and suddenly, ping, you get an SMS, 20,000 in the bank, and you say, wow, mashallah, now we can do what? What happened? What happened? You worked hard for 30 whole days believing another human that he's going to give you some reward after your job. But when Allah promises you that after you work, I'm going to give you, you don't believe Allah.